Greetings, I am Batman, but you might know me as CrossKnights, and this is Batman Arkham Asylum. So on the last episode, I don't know, I'm assuming events happened, haven't played this since, never mind, I'm not going to say the date, because that'd be really confusing given when this is going to be released. Well, I do know that all these plants weren't here before, and they're a little bit of a problem. So I need to try to work to get rid of the source of them, which is, of course, Pamela Isley, also known as Poison Ivy. And I'm just running on this roof because I was like, I need secrets, I need all the secrets, give me all the secrets. I always, whenever there's collections in games, I always get worried that I'm not going to like spend enough time collecting all of them, and then I'm going to be forced to collect them all at the end, which always happens, because I can't just keep on like sprinkling... Was my microphone... Oh, God, it probably sounded weird. I can't just sprinkle it throughout the episodes. Usually it would dilute them too much with, like, finding stuff, and I assume not everyone's interested in this stuff. That being said, I'm really high up, which is cool. Oh, well. There's, like, a secret, like, right below me-ish. I think I'm just gonna leave it. I think we're gonna go to my destination, which is right ahead, right? Actually, I'm pointed directly at it, so it's that building over there, I'm guessing. All right. Ta-da! Here we go. Wow. This is one of the highest places I've ever jumped off of. It's pretty cool, actually. I'm glad that this thing still works, by the way, considering, you know. Yeah. Oh, look at that! Night glider! I just got an achievement for gliding really, really, really far. I think I even got experience for it. Which is a bit weird, because you only get achievements once, don't you? I don't know. Alright, let's see what we shall see.
So you're here at last. Do you like what I've done with the place?
Not really.
My babies are growing, Batman. Come and see.
I mean, I don't even know how to get past your babies at this point. Your babies are grown up, for sure. Good on that. You're an excellent mother. No, I need the line launcher. Where did you guys hide it? Yeah, no, I don't. Wait. This is going to be really useful. Oh. Hey, it was useful. I just found the way over there. Well, fancy that. Alright, paranoid recording check complete. Anytime I've gone a bit without a recording, I gotta make one. Did I already? Yeah, already scanned. Alright, so I've been here before. Hut!
They've got nothing to you!
Several of them did, actually. So, not a good argument. But, you know, you're trying. What the hell? He wasn't there before, was he? Maybe he was. Oh, of course he wasn't. That's a Poison Ivy victim. I don't think she likes any of that. But I warned her. I warned her to go back to her cell.
Such rich food for my babies.
Looks like a lot of the Joker goons that I left here are not okay.
Stop it!
Hell, I'm not okay. Good God, look at my health. I've been taking some lumps. Need to get into a big brawl to restore it. Oh no, oh no, no, no. That was bad. Almost hit me.
You kill Batman just makes me angrier.
Hey, you can get angry as you want. You're not the Hulk.
Are you ready for me? Do you think you can handle me? I'm waiting in here. Come to me.
You don't need to encourage me. That's exactly where I was going. There goes all 20 Joker teeth. Now that weird, like, ratcheter thing, I have no idea how to solve that riddle. Actually, did I get a map in here? I did. Oh, she's a little bit farther than I would have thought. the rat thing's probably either here or here. So let me shoot across and see if I can vent it. Also, it looks like I got some experience, so I'm a bit more healed, which is nice, because those plants are really killing me.
I'll kill you for that, Batman!
Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Lip service, lip service. Mer, mer, mer. Nothing there. Ah, blah. I'm stuck on a thing. Huh. She really tore this place up, didn't she?
Come
Whoa,
to
living
me.
People.
Ivy's waiting. I've got myself a little security, Batman.
You hurt Ivy, Batman.
They'll just die if anything happens to you.
Uh-oh. Alright. Thought he was gonna strike me. Oh god, look at his eyes. They're under her control. Well, she killed all the Joker goons. I guess she needed someone else. I don't know why she didn't just control the Joker goons. But whatever. Either way. Not gonna do anything. Oh, man. Oh, no. The amount of dead in this game. It's a large number. Go away. Maybe I'm not supposed to go that way. I am supposed to go this way. What gives? How am I supposed to get over there, then? Will the line launcher actually work? I don't know about all this. Oh, okay, it moved. Almost there. Not as healed as I'd like to be.
I won't let you destroy it, Batman.
I told you to go to your cell.
I was a fool. I thought the plants were in pain. Now I realize they were evolving, growing stronger.
I am stronger than you, little man. I'll choke the life out of you.
I don't quite remember how to do this. I know it involved something with throwing batarangs. But it was something more than that, wasn't it? I don't know. Also dodging those things. Maybe it was just throwing batarangs.
My plants will tear you and your precious.
Oh, was that those? I have to throw them at those. Right? Yeah, I don't remember. Dodge. Ooh. Oh no, the batarangs are definitely doing damage. Alright. Not as much damage as I'm taking, though, but if I die, hopefully I'll come back with full health. Oh god. I've got a severe timing problem here, clearly. Can I throw a multi-batarang, though? Will that... Can't tell if that did more damage. No, I don't think it did. Oh, because that wasn't a multi-batarang. I didn't hold it. Oh, no, because it only throws one because there's one target. It only does one per target. You can't go throw three at the same target. Okay, I'm so dead.
You're nothing but food now, Batman.
Really needed full health for all that.
You're dead and buried, darling.
So, Batarang Ivy when she opens her protective shell for maximum damage. Maximum. But I was still damaging her even without that. Alright.
Gotham will be mine!
Yeah, just not a lot. And I need to not get hit by those because it does so much damage. Even worse than those little flying thingies.
Give in to a more powerful force, Batman.
Oh, like right there. Damn it. Didn't make it. At least I'm not getting hit. Oh! There we are. That one hit her. Right in the actual body. Instead of weird plant carapace. No! Got her. Whoa! Now there should be a third one, right? Just logically, by game logic. Alright. Whoa! Okay, that was close. It's those little tendril things, like the little spikes. I can't let those hit me, I think. Like, the ivy part looks like it's fanfare. Doesn't actually matter. Yeah. Whoa, no, no, no! Oh god, there's one. Urgh! I've managed to not get hit yet, but that is not gonna stay true, I don't think. Oh, yep, there it is. No, get her! Yes! And as long as that could, like, kill you in, like, one round, this is really not desirable. Boom. Whoa! I took some hits there. Ow. What the hell? Oh, explosive gel.
Don't, please!
Really? Alright, well, it looks like this is a round two situation.
He's trying to hurt me.
No good. Oh no! She's. It's the bewitched guards. Oh no, no, no! Yeah, let's break some guards' arms. It'll be fine. Sure, there won't be any repercussions for that. Ah, they probably won't even remember.
You cannot beat Mother Nature, but she can destroy you.
Pop. Yeah, that does like 3 to 4 times more damage if I hit her when it's open. That doesn't mean I shouldn't be throwing constantly, though, because... Hurt! Oh, that one's gonna hit her. Yeah. And multi-shot. You're getting predictable, Ivy. Keep it that way, please. Oh, will I make it? Oh, you made it. And the multi. Alright. Hopefully she doesn't have more guards.
Save me from the evil bat.
Whoa! It sounds like she has more guards. Throw. Oh! Almost rolled right into it. I can almost ignore them, can't I? Whoa! Yeah. She's killing her own guys, alright. At the very least, stunning them.
I need help here, boys.
Oh my god, she called more guards? Okay.
Pressure.
Maybe I can't ignore them. Yeah. No, no, no! Oh god. Not good. Alright, I gotta keep on throwing. I just gotta pay attention for when her attack comes. Sadly, throwing batarangs at her does not count for my combo. Else this would be a little bit easier. Also, my strategy of ignoring the guards isn't that good, because then she doesn't get to this phase as fast, and this is when she becomes vulnerable. Alright, one more hit. Yep. Yeah, I really thought there'd be a round three. Nope, I'm getting out of here. Alright, hello.
You don't want to miss it. So get your ass over to the sound block, or you'll miss your final surprise.
So here's the deal. I didn't realize how close to the end of the game I was. I'm pretty sure this is going to the end of the game once the fireworks start. That means I really should have been so paranoid about using, not finding all the secrets, because there's tons of them. There's like 100 of them that I haven't found. So now I'm not even quite sure what I should do. I could do a special episode thing, or I just find a crap ton of secrets. I figure I want to at least keep, like, the audio stuff in this episode, you know? I don't know. I don't know what to do. If only I could vote on it. I can't, though, because backlog to hell. Also, upgrade. Let's just get the final health upgrade. I really just didn't. I got those gel upgrades. Maybe I didn't play around with them enough, but I just didn't care about them. But yeah. What do I do? All right, let's take some inventory. Let's ignore the fact that there's a terrifyingly large amount of question marks right in front of me. Oh, boy. Riddler challenge. So, yeah. A little bit less than 100 more to find.
Can we just agree I'm cleverer than you?
No. Let's face it, there are two dents on the wall. I must have to find, like, a Harvey Dent poster. What do I do? By the way, thanks to the person, like, episodes and episodes ago that told me about the tape that I missed in that guard tower. But, you know, I did get it. I got it last episode. But someone actually told me, and that was appreciated. So, it looks like there's something in here. Damn it. I'm in a bat quandary. I think I'm going to look for some secrets. I think that's what my plan is. And then maybe I'll beat the game. But once I beat the game, am I going to want to go back and get... Oh, God. Where the hell did he come from? I really didn't notice that guy. Oh, man. Oh, God, is there another one? Oh, he's over there. I don't think he sees me. Oh, look at that, vote dent. There we go. No, didn't give me anything. I bet that would have given me Two-Face if I hadn't already had Two-Face. So I think some of them are profiles that have more than one way of appealing. Damn it! Countered at the wrong time, then I failed to punch him. Oops. Now I'm failing to finish him. Alright, secret expedition. Crap, now what do I do, though? Because... I don't want to... I could just go and beat the game, though, couldn't I? Well, we'll see. I'll start collecting, and I'll see how I feel. Yeah. I think that works. Alright, let's get to it. Do I want to start this systematically? Alright, I'll just start looking around here. Okay, I think I might have been wrong. I think this was the interview tape that they were talking about.
I've been a fool. Joker was behind it all. He's Jack White. He gave me the money, pulled the strings to release Bane. How could I not have seen it? He's been blackmailing me. He has a crazy plan to create an army of monsters. I want out, but it... Hello? Hello? Dr. Young's office.
Please help.
What?
Hello, Doc. We need to talk.
another lie?
Who knows? I certainly don't, but let's not get distracted with details. So, anyway, I want my monsters.
I sent you back the money. I don't want it.
Do I look like I care about money? I just want my monsters, Doc. And if you don't give them to me, well then, it won't be funny.
So that was the final Joker thing. Yeah, I think, yeah, that's the one the person told me was on the guard tower. I don't know. There was tapes in guard towers. One of them someone told me, because I'm apparently bad at seeing them there. I also found so many secrets that now I get this. Let's get this, just whatever. I don't even know if I want that last upgrade, damn it. I'm going to try to find these two secrets now. Because, you know, there's good background information that I haven't found in some of the secrets yet, and I think that's worth showing. And if... What? Hey, diddle, diddle, where? Where? Usually only says that when I'm close to a riddle. Yeah, but there's information that I want. And I'm pretty sure I'm going to play Arkham City at this point. It's like I keep on going back and forth on which game is better at this point. This game was definitely more pure. It had less... crap. It had less filler. Now, as much as I liked the Joker Riddler riddles better in Arkham City just because they were actual puzzles, there's too many of them. There's like 400, and a lot of them are not fun to get. A lot of them are just annoying to get. So, I don't know. I don't know which one did it better. I think 200 would have been fine, guys. They didn't need to fill, like, every single indoor area with, like, 20 different Riddler trophies that weren't puzzle-based. They could have just had it, like, if all of the Riddler trophies were outside, or most of them anyway, and they all took puzzles, that would have been awesome. I would have loved that. Alright, well, I gotta be honest. This is the first time I have looked up a puzzle in this game. Part of me didn't want to do it. I was just like, I'm gonna try to get as far as I can with all of the puzzles before looking it up, but then I'm just like, I'm already here. So... right here. I went past it more than once. It was just so annoying. Because it was on the map. It kept on being below me. It's just this. The map wasn't incredibly helpful for finding this because there's so much upward mobility at this map that it could have been like anywhere still. But all right. So there's that. Are you kidding me? There was. I just walked by this, didn't I? Oh well.
I argued with the latest group of young, eager doctors. They bored me with theories and ideas, proving that they had no theories on how to cure these animals. Only one shared my vision. I offered her the chance to explore her dreams. She accepted. We'll make a good team.
I don't know who he's talking about. And I don't know if I got this far on the Arkham story things. I might have. But yeah, this is done. I'm wrong. There's another one. Oh, no. All right, I'm going to have to go all the way back to the Batcave to get that one. Alright, right in front of me. This is not an area I wanted to ever come back to, for God's sakes. Where is the thing? It says it's pointing this direction. I guess I'll just fly over here and hope it works out. Oh, there it is. Whew. Alright, I don't think I've ever cleared out an entire Riddler section before either, so that's kind of cool. I was hoping you'd give me some type of extra statement, but I guess not. This is where that stupid elevator thing... The part where I went down to Killer Croc's area, and the Scarecrow was like, "Mer words!" Looks like I didn't find this grate over here, so we got an Arkham secret, and then we got a... place that leads to nowhere. It's just there for fun, apparently. Just nice, fun, nothing. Aroo! There we are.
The Gotham police dragged a new patient to the island. They said he was responsible for the disappearance of hundreds of the city's vagrants. As I looked at his disgusting body, all scales and teeth, my mind ran free, dreaming of delicious punishments to break this monster. Doctors gathered around, poking it, examining. But only I knew what would cure him, once and for all.
Was it death? Was that a thing you cured him with? Was it with killing him? I'm guessing so. Alright, few more. There's a puzzle where it said Dr. Crane's something gets elevated to new heights, and it obviously has something to do with the elevator. I just can't figure out what. Or was it to new depths?
Dr. Jonathan Crane plans on elevating fear to new depths.
See, depths would suggest low. An elevator. Yeah, so it's like below the elevator. I wonder if I can call the elevator. Here's a grate right above the elevator that I don't know if I've gone to before. I have. Oh my. Oh my. This looks like a secret room of some kind. Oh, he was watching me as I was coming in. Okay. I mean, someone's been keeping a lot of tabs on me. There it is. I mean, who was this? What the... This is really, really blurry, and I'm not able to read it, so I don't know what's going on here, but it's quite odd. I'm wondering if this is like one of the game devs or something, but this is a weird little secret, and there's more of them here, huh? I think they're all the same. Something floating cage, it's so blurry. Oh, alright. Alright, climbed all the way to the top. There's some teeth I missed. Looks like there's something in here. Let's see, hook up with the relatives before you're transferred out of here. I remember that. And there's a door I never went to before. Yeah, deactivate that sucker. Oh, climbing up that elevator, by the way. Very annoying. Much easier to go down with... Ow. Alright, I jumped the gun a little bit. Read me that. Oh, hello.
Can't you tell me how these got in my office?
Oh, really? I put them there. Why? You don't like flowers?
I think the guards would be interested to know you've been out of your cell.
Oh, if you really were going to tell, you already wouldn't.
How do you know I haven't already?
Oh, sweet. I like you. I really do. Even your name. Rework it a bit and we get...
Harley Quinn, like the clown. I know, I've heard it before.
It's a name that puts a smile on my face. It makes me think there's someone here I can relate to. Someone who might like to hear my secrets.
Really? Go on.
Not here, my dear. Too many ears and eyes. Come back tonight. I'll be ready for you.
Yep, they, oh, what is this? Oh, God, it's Cash's family. Yeah. Yeah, I actually just saw, a few days ago, I saw Suicide Squad. And I actually liked it quite a bit. It was definitely not without its flaws. It certainly had problems. I'm not gonna say any spoilers or anything, I'm not that guy. But, I liked it. As an action movie, it was good. I mean, I guess I can stop there. As an action movie, it was good. It went through a whole lot of production problems. And it makes me maybe not want to write off all the DC movies, because I love the Marvel movies that have been coming out, but I have not really liked the DC movies in a while. I think I'm actually going to watch Batman vs. Superman, even though I completely wrote that off to the point where I didn't even want to watch it. But, you know, I'll give it a chance. I'd say if you watch it, and it's probably not in theaters anymore, but if you're going to watch it, just go in there with low expectations. And, you know, if they're low enough, it should, you know, exceed them possibly, or at the very least meet them. But yeah, I don't know. I enjoyed it for the most part. Okay, so I've decided what I'm going to do. I'm not going to beat the game this episode. I am going to find a bunch of secrets, and I realized, usually I do have music, like I did a little bit earlier, and then I suddenly realized, why don't I just play the audio files over me seeing the things? That'll kill two birds with one batarang. So, I mean, it'll knock the birds out, obviously. Batman doesn't kill things. So right now I'm finding all of the secrets on top of Arkham Mansion, and in the background I'm going to play the four pieces of the Armadeus story thing over this. And then I guess I'll go over the character profiles that I find at the end. But it's going to be Arkham Mansion, which is what I'm doing now, and then once I find all the things around Arkham Mansion, and it's like some of the stuff outside of the Botanical Gardens, I will go into the Botanical Garden, because there was a lot of secrets in that one room where you can grapple up to anything, and a few just random ones that I missed. So, let's get on with that.
The beast was too strong. His animal savagery nearly cost me my life. I took my frustrations out on a lone patient. His case notes suggested he was a paranoid schizophrenic. His pleas, as I beat him to death, suggested much more. His confessions were illuminating. My path was clear. Every day I found the patients more distracting. Their insane mutterings and constant twitching disgusted me. There was only one way to cure this evil. Only one way to purify the city and ensure its future. I needed to prepare myself. I needed to be ready. I had a sudden pang of conscience. I sought counsel from my priest on the choices I had made. I asked him if it was a sin to kill in order to save a life. The holy man said all life was sacred, but a judgment would not be upon my soul if I acted to save another. I left the confessional with my soul uplifted, convinced more than ever I am doing a service not only to mankind, but to God as well.
What? You found 75% of my challenges? This can't be right.
I watched in silence as he brought in the woman. Her skin, now a venomous green. The wanton creature no longer looked like a human being, much less a woman. The Bible says, suffer not a witch to live. Yet he has once again delivered this female atrocity to our care. Once I have dealt with the monster, I think it will be time to see if green wood does, in fact, burn.
So there was way more footage than audio files. I probably should have figured that out. So I guess music now. I don't know. I used Machinarium before. I don't know what I'm going to use this time. We'll see. But it's about 5 more minutes. At the very end, I'll go over the two profiles that I found.
hurt all over. What happened?
What happened?
So that music, for anyone curious, was Castle Crescendo, which is a remixed Donkey Kong Country 2 song, and I need to post the link to the album. It's free. It was released Creative Commons. It might be my favorite remixed video game album of all time, so I would suggest checking it out, and I use it in quite a few of my videos. So, the two profiles. We have... Oh, that's nice to see. Ugh. You don't have to yell, buddy. Alright, we have the rat catcher, who I was calling the ratcheter. My god, definitely never heard of him. So let's see. Otis, professional criminal. He used to actually be a rat catcher. Somehow, miraculously, not 6 feet. Must be a minor guy. Thorough knowledge of Gotham sewer. Eerie ability to wordlessly communicate with and command all rats. Overvalues rodent life, especially in comparison to human life. That seems to be a theme. He's kind of like Poison Ivy, but with rats. And then Humpty Dumpty, who I sort of mentioned before, he's a little bit different just because when he was sent to Arkham, he was a model inmate, apparently. He wasn't, because, I mean, I guess he's not, like, really evil. He's huge. He is a massive man. Extremely tall, heavy, and strong. Possesses an almost unnaturally quiet, deliberate nature. Ritualized child abuse has led to a severe case of arrested development and an inability to assimilate into modern society, and obsessed with the process of assembly and disassembly. Reassembly and disassembly. So, yes, next episode, I'm going to go to a party. And hopefully people found this episode okay. I mean, I guess the first, like... I mean, one-third of it was at least a boss battle. And I guess I hopefully gave ample warning that the rest was going to be a lot of, you know, just looking for things. So, I guess I'll see you later. This LP's almost over. Huh. It's kind of hard to think. I feel like I've been doing it for quite a while. All right. I'll see you guys later. Bye.